Jesse Jordan.
birthday. I got a 3-year-old at home.
Touch of his significant other sent a tingle down his whole body. The fact that they would even bother to commit something so naughty. Warm water began to cascade over their bodies while they embraced. It had been so long since they'd played, they always had to work with haste. Distance makes the heart grow fonder. So meeting like this was exuberant. Their appendages began to wander as they covered each other in lubricant. Wrapped up like two coiling snakes, they explored every crevice and nook, giving each other all they can take. Then suddenly, it all ended with a look. Their passionate encounter had ended just as soon as it had begun, and though it was truly spended, they knew it had to be done. 20 seconds was all it would take, and they were both really big fans. Their hearts would continue to ache until the next time you washed your hands.
alone in 10 when you're as good as me. Step it back. Let me show you how it's done.
We don't kill people in that desert.
For me. I love it.
Kill you!
No, please don't. Ah.
I'm a veteran, I don't fall for that.
No.
Oh, nothing. Thank you. Yep. Get your gear, goof. Come on, Kelly!
He wants to do the introductions.
People of Overland Park, Kansas, my name is Drew Gold, and I have a stern warning for everybody in the crowd and everybody watching on television with a child present. What you are about to witness is a barbaric destruction of a human being. You are going to see limbs ripped from torsos. You are going to see bones snapped, tendons torn, because you are about to go one-on-one with a safari-like encounter with a raging bull, Maverick!
Man, nobody does an intro quite like Drew Gold for his main man who is going to try to walk out as champion tonight. There's that look of intensity that we've been accustomed to seeing on the Raging Bull's face.
Wrestling fans, this match scheduled for one fall is for the Spirit of NWL Championship. There must be a winner. Introducing first the challenger, accompanied by Drew Gold from Georgetown, Texas. Weighing 245 pounds, this is Maverick.
And like you heard him say, man, Midnight Guthrie said there must be a winner. That is the rule for the Spirit of NWL Championship. Look out, what is this?
Oh, look at Gary J. Wants to jumpstart this matchup because he knows
Gary
he has
J.
to beat the Raging Bull and do it quickly.
Look at that, just blindsided from behind. What is, oh, no.
Oh, look at Topay Suicida. His lower back just crashed into that security railing. And that's two of them. Look at Gary J coming out, firing on all cylinders here.
He hasn't even taken off his vest yet. Come on, referee, stop this.
He's going for the trifecta. And he just, look at that, puts Maverick over that security railing. All hell has broken loose in tonight's main event.
And look at that, security guards down. Maverick is just laying out there in the crowd. Gary J just, first of all, let's talk about what a cheater he is. Just destroying him from behind and continuing to three dives, been three.
Three Tope Suicidas and just put some pain into the back of Maverick. He saw his back pinned in an awkward position over that. Look at that, using his t-shirt now to choke Maverick. This is a smart decision by Gary J.
This is ridiculous. You know what this means? It means he's scared. It means he knows he has to do this to try to get the upper hand, because he knows if Maverick has the upper hand, he's done.
This means he doesn't want to get folded up like an accordion again through one of those tables. He knows he has to start this early. Oh, gosh, you hear that knife-edge chop echo off the chest of the Raging Bull.
I still think I see shards of table in his back from when he got thrown like a sack of garbage through there a few weeks ago. And Maverick, I want you to do it again tonight.
Gary J, and like you heard him say right before this matchup, he plans on using his heart, his intestinal fortitude to overcome the size, the strength, and quite frankly, the rage of Maverick.
You know, Maverick does look upset all the time. He looks mad. He looks like someone you don't want to mess with, and that's what makes him great in professional wrestling. People are intimidated to talk to him, even do anything to him like this. Gary J's just stupid. That's why he's doing it.
I think I still have a lump on the back of my head from my last encounter with the Raging Bull. And look at this. Picking up Gary J and drape. Oh, he usually drapes him over that rope. But Gary J turns it into a DDT. Nicely done by Gary J.
Maverick is in deep trouble. I never thought this was going to be the way it was going to lay out tonight. I mean, he is down there on the floor. Gary J, though, wasting valuable time as he starts talking to the crowd.
And don't forget, like you said, Ryan, there must be a winner here tonight. No countouts, no disqualifications. There has to be a pinfall or a submission in this Spirit of the NWL title match.
Come on.
Yeah, just pulling apart the fangs.
Gary J, you're in too good of a mood right now. Do you understand who you're talking? You're in there with Maverick.
The jam-packed crowd here in Overland Park. Look at this. We're chanting for Gary J.
Uh-oh. Come on, Mav. Yes. Wait,
what is he doing? No. God, no. Oh, God. A German suplex on the outside just dropped him right on his head.
Did he land right on his head? I mean, look at that. It didn't look like it touched his back. It looked like it spiked him right on the top of his head.
That's what these guys are willing to do for the Spirit of the NWL title. The Raging Bull wants to end the reign of Gary J, but more importantly, he may want to end the career of the Stiff Robo Ginger.
Man, Gary, I don't know if you can actually do anything to harm this guy. I mean, this guy continues to walk. He took that on his head. He goes through a table. I mean, the only thing that sometimes I wonder, what can Maverick do to stop this guy ever? I mean, it's incredible.
Gary J may have the highest threshold for pain that I've ever seen.
This side of Mick Foley. Yeah. I mean, come on, this guy's
absolutely
a sadist.
Slow to get up to his feet. He may not be. He may have some serious neck and head injuries after taking that German suplex on the outside.
Let's face it. I don't know if any of us are going to be able to tell if he has any brain injuries after tonight. Did he exit Goofy before he came into the ring?
Drew Gold pacing like a kid, like a madman on the outside. One team needing the Raging Bull to get this victory here tonight so they can get some extra zeros on that paycheck and listen to those knife-edge chops.
Man, and this is what Gary didn't want when he jumped on the back of Maverick.
The word stiff gets thrown around a lot in professional wrestling, but that was a stiff clothesline.
Every time Maverick is on the offensive, Gary somehow fights back.
Gary J has a lot of heart. He is right about that. You can't, not even you, Ryan, can take that away from him. This guy will take a licking and keep on ticking as he's doing right here. I mean, he just took a German suplex on the floor.
And he continues to battle back with Maverick. Look at these elbows. Come on, Drew. Yes.
Come on. This. Oh, another German split. He stood right up and then just got turned inside out with a clothesline. This may do it. One, two. Gary J kicks out.
That German suplex, Mav threw him so far, he landed on his front. I mean, he totally skipped his back and his head. That's why Gary's able to get up. That's the strength of Maverick. He's pulling him up by his beard.
Oh, just slaps him, just paintbrushes him across the face.
The problem is, and Maverick has to know this by now, when you do painful stuff to Gary, he just continues to want more. It's weird.
Oh, God.
Look at that elevation.
Look at that drop kick. No. Somebody with the muscle mass of Maverick shouldn't be able to do such a picture-perfect drop kick.
Man. And Maverick, if Stairs could talk, he cannot believe that Gary is still rolling around. And he's reaching out to the fans for help. And Maverick is just sitting there. Can't believe what he's seeing.
Most men would have been put away by some of the moves that Maverick has done to Gary J in tonight's main event. But Gary J loves the fans and loves the spirit of the NWL title and does not want to lose it here tonight.
Elbow.
Oh. Back elbow, Gary J.
Oh, man.
That sole of the boot right across the bridge of the nose. And there's that spinning flatliner that he loves to use to great effect. Drops Maverick right on his face.
Could have broken his nose.
But he's unable to make that cover, giving Maverick valuable seconds to get back up to his feet.
Drew Gold over there screaming at Maverick to wake up. He can't stay down on the ground. He has to continue to take out Gary J. Because I don't know if we found the level of pain that it will take for Gary J to lose this championship.
There's both men struggling. Referee Nick Chin waiting for both of these men to get back up to their feet. Both men have inflicted damage upon each other, and both men want that spirit title. Look at that slap.
You hear that? Who's gonna get the upper hand here?
One of these slaps and I would be knocked unconscious, but that's the kind of warriors that we have in the NWL.
Look at that, both men a little.
Oh God, you saw the spit fly out of Maverick's mouth with that last shot.
Yeah, look, come on.
Trying to boot to the midsection, jumping knee right to the face of the Raging Bull, elevates him over. Look at that. Come nice on, head scissors takeover by Gary J.
Uh-oh.
Elevates him again, and that knee connected right with the jaw of the Raging Bull low cross body.
Uh-oh.
Maverick rolls through.
Look at this. It's over. Look at the strength.
I was just about to say, look at the strength of the Raging Bull. That look of determination in his eyes that nobody will stop him here tonight. Oh, gosh, sits out with that powerbomb, too. No,
man.
So close. Gary J kicks out.
Come on, Nick Chin. Don't give me that 2 inches garbage. It was over. 1, 2, 3. Come on, Maverick. Maverick's as tall as Nick Chin on his knees. Come on, take him out. This referee is really getting involved in stuff too much, and he can't count to three.
What is Maverick doing, trying to intimidate Nick Chin? Nick Chin doing the best job that he can. Maverick needs to stay on the attack.
He does.
If he expects to pick up a victory over the resilient Gary J.
As horrible as the referee is, you need to stay on him, Mav. Come on.
Powerbomb. He's giving Nick Chin so much guff, man. That guy's a good referee.
Says
oh, no.
You.
We've said this might be a repeat of when Maverick powerbombed him off the apron.
Yeah, just go
but
to
there's
the floor
no table.
Time. Go to the floor. Yes.
Oh, no, no. Oh, thank gosh. He rolls into the ring. Oh, kicking the legs out.
Uh-oh.
Oh, knee lift right to the face.
He has really been bashing Maverick's face with those knees. Oh, no, not the
double stomp right in the back of the head. Nicely executed by Gary J. Drapes one arm over. Now he tries to pull him away from those ropes, too. No! And Maverick kicks out.
And Gary J now can't believe he didn't win. That double stomp under the face. He's hit that face multiple times with knees. And Maverick's still kicking out. Drew Gold is pulling out his hair.
Remember, it was about a year ago that Maverick suffered a concussion that kept him out of action. Who knows if that double stomp to the back of the head could do some damage, and Gary J may use that opening to pick up the victory.
Come on, Mav. Wake up. This crowd doesn't know what they're doing.
Crowd firmly behind Gary J in this encounter. Gary J taking his time, making his way up to the top rope. That could be a costly mistake. Look at that, Maverick out of the other corner and just turned him inside out with that lariat. And now what is he doing here?
Here we go.
Oh, we haven't seen this in a long, long time.
I love
and
this.
It's back, the short shot. Drops him right on his face. Rolls him over, 1, 2, and 3.
Yes.
And we have a new Spirit of the NWL champ.
You deserve it.
Wrestling fans, your winner, and new Spirit of NWL champion, Maverick.
Look at this, he's obsessed over winning that championship, and congratulations, buddy, you finally did it.
No chairs, no candlesticks, no tables, no trash cans. Just all aggression and brutality led Maverick back to the Spirit of the NWL title. What an exclamation point for that big man.
And Maverick, I suggest you go in and tell Matt Jackson thank you for giving you this championship rematch against Gary J. You won the title. Congratulations, pal. You worked so hard.
We were high. Yes!
Yeah.
Yeah. Dick Rudy. Kick his ass.
Oh! for 6 months thinking I left the state in a better shape. But then I come here, Chandler, and I see your bitch ass face, and it makes me despicable to be from this state. If you want it, you earn it, you little bitch.
Go away.